You lift me up, fill my eyes with wonder. For every young in your love, this freedom's untainted. With you, no moment is wasted.
Today, you may know this precious family just like I do. This is the Seppings family. Would you like to wave hello to them? This is Nikki and Dino and their three beautiful children, Zoe, Malachi, and Seth. Guys, thank you for joining us today.
Thanks for having us, Jojo.
It is such a treat to have you back in the kitchen because I know you've been on Character Kitchen a couple of times this season. But today we've asked you to come for a very special reason, because we are continuing our series on the miracles of God, and this family represents two amazing miracles that we'd love to talk into today. So guys, will you start from the very beginning for us? Next, how did the journey begin of having this beautiful family?
Jojo, it's a long story, but a beautiful story, and I think it will be too long to tell the whole story, but just after Dean and I got married, obviously, naturally, you want to have kids, and when I was a little girl, I prayed and asked God for kids, and he showed me a picture of what my family would look like, and it looks like it does today. So when Dean and I started to try for a family, we couldn't fall pregnant at the time, and we did fertility treatments and nothing was happening. So we went to the Lord to ask the Lord, what's going on? What should we do? And the Lord showed me a picture of a beautiful little brown princess. And I received that picture and I just prayed into it. And the Lord led Dean and I to a Tembeletu, and we went to a Tembeletu, and we started the adoption journey.
So precious.
And a lot of people say it can take a very long time, but for Dean and I, the miracle was that it only took 3 months. It was a very quick process and journey for us. And we have got this beautiful, precious daughter that we are overwhelmed with what God has done in our lives. And and there's so much more to it and what God did in the whole journey. But so that is the miracle of Zoe. And then we were so happy with Zoe. We said to the Lord, we would love to continue this special journey. And so we decided that we weren't going to try for any more fertility, but we were going to trust the Lord for another adoption.
Oh, and I remember the day Mally came home. I still remember it. We were all living next door to each other at Live Village, and it was such a precious time. Yes. And do you remember when we were next door neighbors, Zoe?
Yeah.
Hey, and you and Liv Liz still best friends today. Hey,
yeah.
Because we were all one happy family on the village.
Yeah.
And then Mally came, and tell us all about Mally, because I remember you made your presence known from the beginning.
So then we were ready to have a second child. And we were just so overwhelmed by what God did in our lives with Zoe and just how blessed we were. And so then we went back to Timbaletu and we just said, look, we are just so overwhelmed. We would love to have a little boy. And within 2 months, we went to go and get our second child, Malachi Josiah. And so it was our second adoption. And that was our family. We were just so content and so overwhelmed with what God had done in our lives.
Such a
and
miracle.
The miracle of these precious children. Mm.
So beautiful. Thank you for sharing. And Mally and Zozo, it's like you've been here forever. It's like God knew that you were planted in this family forever and ever. God knew, and it was already written in his book. I find that amazing. God already knew from the very beginning.
Yes.
You are such precious children.
Yeah.
We love you so much.
When I was a little girl and God had showed me a picture of what my family would look like. And then when I was so young, I didn't understand. But now I fully understand the miracle of what God has done.
Of what he's done.
Yeah.
That is just totally incredible. Mm-hmm. And then there's a little Sethi in the middle. So how did Sethi come to be here? Hey, Sethi?
I always tell Zoe that she is actually the miracle, because Zoe brought healing to me and Dean and to our hearts.
Wow.
Because a lot of the fertility problems that I had all went away when Zoe came into our lives. Mm. So she brought healing, and it's because of her and Jesus that we actually were able to miraculously conceive
without fertility.
And we woke up one day and we were pregnant, and God gave us our third child.
Isn't that just beautiful?
Yeah.
Well, I just get so excited every time I see your family, because your family is a picture of what Jesus can do if we trust in him.
Amen.
And if we trust in God's ways, and God is that good.
Yes.
Hey? Yeah. Do you know what he says in the Bible in Ephesians 1, my favorite scripture in all the Bible? It says that we are loved, that we are chosen, that we are adopted into God's family, that we are the children of God,
Amen.
That we've been sealed by the Holy Spirit, which is the guarantee that he's always with us.
Yes.
And we have a promise in heaven, eternal life with him forever.
Mm.
And when I look at your children, Nix and Dino, I'm reminded of those beautiful promises.
Mm.
And you have such a gift in being able to illuminate identity in your children. Dino, talk into that for a little bit, help the families out there today. How do you instill sonship and identity into your children?
So that's such a good question, Joe. For me, first of all, when I see my daughter and my two sons, it's been quite miraculous, because for me, I don't see any difference. To the outside world, we'll see a different color skin.
Sure.
But to us, there's absolutely no difference. Honestly, it's a supernatural thing where it's a son and a daughter.
Mm, of course.
And so God's done something so miraculous in my life through the process of adoption and having children, because I've realized that I'm a son. And not because of how good I am or how good my test results are, or how well I do, or how hard I work even, but I'm a son because I'm chosen.
Amen.
And no one can take that away. And
Amen.
So that's been a huge journey for me in becoming a father, is that our identity is secure in who Jesus says we are.
Yes.
And so for me, it's just about being honest, being open, being truthful, and being yourself. And we're all on a journey. We're not perfect parents. We don't pretend to be. And our kids have been super gracious to us, Hazel, Malachi and Seth, as we've journeyed through this. So how we instill identity, I think, is just speaking life and being ourselves and doing life together. Yeah.
That is just so precious. That's
and
so
also
true.
And also, children are a gift from the Lord. And you know, it doesn't matter how they come. It's that they all come from
they
God.
Are just so such a gift. And I think of that scripture that says, blessed is the man whose quiver is full of them. Hey, that talking, referring about the arrows. I was thinking of that scripture this last week, how those arrows are our children. We don't realize as those little precious arrows are being sharpened and they're being sent out, they represent us and they protect us. I think in the old days, I think you young guys would protect the mums and dads when they got older. Hey, it would be like the young sons would have to go out and protect your mum and dad with the arrows, like a soldier.
Can
do that.
Yeah.
And you'll do that one day for your mum and dad, won't you?
He will.
Yeah, you will, Melly. And you'll protect your mum and dad one day.
He's very protective of his mom.
busy. Yeah. Boys and girls, I have just loved hearing the story of this beautiful family and what it means to be the family of God. And I'm so encouraged, and I'm sure you are too. Let's praise God together, shall we? Let's enter into the Father's love and just receive the love of the Father this morning, wherever you might be sitting, wherever you might be, and whoever you might be with. Let's trust the Lord that as we open our hearts to His love today, that He will fill you with the love of a Father for His children, just like He does these precious children in front of us. Let's receive the Lord right now in Jesus' name. Amen. Are you ready to worship?
Amen. Amen.
Oh, I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night, and you tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. Oh, and I've seen many searching for it.
You are perfect in all of your ways.
Who you are.
Dear Lord Jesus, thank you for this wonderful day. Please bless all those people who can't have children, and please can you just know that they are a child of God.
Yes.
In Jesus' name, amen.
Thank you, Lord. Amen.
Yes, Father, we just want to say thank you for this privilege. Thank you for the privilege of being parents. Thank you for the privilege of being called your children, Lord, because of what you've done by sending your Son, Father God, Jesus Christ, for us. That Jesus, you died for us, that you rose again, and you choose us, and you give us the right to be called children of God. You adopt us into your family. And so thank you, Father, that today we can just release a spirit of adoption over everybody, a spirit of reconciliation, that you will call us together in unity once again, and that we can rise up to be the family of God that you've called us all to be. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, amen. Lord. Amen. 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 Thank you, guys. What a special blessing it's been to have you here. And guys, I think we need to do 5 big claps to clap us out.
Yes.
Can we do that?
Yes.
5 big claps. Do you know why I asked them to do 5 claps? Because 5 claps is the number of grace. And we can't live without Jesus. Amen?
Amen.
And this miracle story has been because of the grace of God. So before we leave this place and sing Amazing Grace, let's do 5 big claps for Jesus. Are you ready? Will you join us at home, boys and girls? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Jesus!
Yes, amen.
That's cool.
Bye, everybody, and see you next Sunday.
Bye, guys.
Bye.
Have a great week.
the cure.